Hi there. Say goodbye to boring beats in Logic Pro X. In this session, we will look into how to use internal sequencer with external drum machine like TR-8S. So let's get going with Logic Pro X. So in Logic Pro X, they have had a step sequencer for a while, and how to use it with external drum machines is quite straightforward. What I have done is, of course, I have done this configuration already before, and I have a template for my TR-8S so that when I start the project, I can pull this configuration in. There I have basically a folder in which I have a MIDI track in which I can send the MIDI information. Then I have 11 audio tracks mapped into the external input that brings the audio from TR-8S into Logic. And then, of course, you need to arm those so they are in a monitoring mode so that you hear them all. And that's pretty much it. Then, of course, you could create your own configuration regarding on the effects and so on and so forth, what you want to use and while basically working with your mixer. So let's move to step sequencer. That's the tool that you use when doing a programming. So you need to open up an editor, and in this case it will open for you a step sequencer where basically you have these different lines and that represent a track or a pad in a drum machine. And I have already pre-configured all these so that I have mapped them with the keys, mapping the right note into the one that is playing it in TR-8S, for example. So you would need to find out that, you know, what note you need to send to your external drum machine in order it to kind of launch the right pad that you want to launch. And how to do that is kind of, there are many ways to do it, but one thing is that you basically go, once you have all the audio mapped and you go here, you have another external keyboard and you basically go and find out that what the key is. In this case, it's this seems to be C#2. So now I would go here. And this is actually what you need to do, all of this. So I have done this in already so that we don't lose time to do these mappings for all these pads and tracks in TR-8S. So I just show this as an example that how to add it. So you go into the note and now you want to add a C#2. So then you would like to change that track to the end so that they are in the same order as your channels here. So now if I click here, you can see that it is launching CC, so cymbal in this case. And here, if you right click, you can go and rename. So you can basically name this as a CC as well, so that it represents the same name as you have in a TR-8S. In this case, of course, if you have another external drum machine, you can, you know, use the naming that reflects that and the channels or pads that are coming in from that. And then we have one more to go, which is RC. And that's there. It seems to be D#, two. So you then go and you say, oh, sorry, not that one. You go into the plus and you go into the notes and then D#2. And then now if you play that one, you can see that that is now correctly mapped. And then you can, of course, not here, but here when you go and right click, you can rename it also accordingly. So now once you have all these renamed, then basically you have done your thing. You can test it also that it fires all the, you know, the channels or pads so that you kind of do a simple kind of like a pattern like this. And now if you start to play, you can see that everything fires. So And let's move into the mixer so I can see that everything is basically now going there. So it works. So the mapping is now correct. Then next thing what you can do is that in an editor you have an ability to save this as a template, so that you don't need to recreate it all the time when you start from scratch. So you basically go here, you need to click on this pattern browser, and then here is an action that you can basically say an action, and then you can say that, okay, save a pattern or save a template. In this case you want to save a template because that represents the notes and the kind of the tracks that you have done. The pattern would be the pattern that you have wrote over here. So you can actually recall your templates and you can recall your patterns. So now we go into the template mode, and then you can there actually name the template. I can name it TR8S template 2, for example. I already had a previous template over there, but let's use this TR8S template 2. So now if I would go and I basically go and delete this, so I said that's okay, let's delete that. And as you can see now, this goes into the default mode, so it is not representing the one that we had. So you can go always into your user settings and then pull in the template, and then you know how you have them correctly now represented. If you would like to change these icons as well, so you can of course do that also, so that you can go when you are on top of the icon, you can go and basically then, you know, right clicking it, you can go into the drums, and from there you can basically then, you know, find the icon that you would like to use, like a kick drum and snare and tom and so on and so forth. So this is basically this is the way that you can then bring these icons into your template. So if I would like that to be represented as a kick drum, I'll right click. What would remind me as a snare? I could basically use maybe these two look like more like that could be my snare, for example. Let's see, there isn't equivalent here, so of course you can choose to select any of these icons that you see here, and what is kind of convenient from your point of view. Then you have basically option to bring your own custom icons, so you can actually create your own icons and bring them here. And that's the way you can then configure. And then of course you need to basically, you know, save the pattern. No, not the pattern, sorry. You can basically then go and say that save the template. And it will always looks like it will always save as a new template. So that's one thing. But you can go into the folder and delete this if you want. So you can also go here and basically delete these patterns from here. So like you say delete patterns, so you don't get hundreds of them. So you can basically say, okay, delete pattern, yes, please delete. And then you can go over here and you can also do then that, you know, when you save the pattern, you could basically then give a name like just TR8S, and that's it. At least now they are correct in this, so let's do a test. Let's delete this loop. Okay, and we are in the baseline, and then we would need to go and recall things. Okay, now it remembers it, so I don't know, there was some maybe miss thing from my end, so that I didn't save it correctly and that messed up the thing. But now you can basically then go and program your drum pattern in a way that you want, And then, you know, that's pretty much it from how to use a sequencer with an external drum machine. Of course, these mappings and the storing are the most important thing for you to do and take out from here. Then that's the dingy, and then now if we play, everything works great, and you have pretty much all that stuff now in place. So this is how to use Logic Pro 11 sequencer, and of course this sequencer has been with Logic Pro X for a while. So this is how you create the sequencer. You store it here so that you need to remember to open from here and then go and save a template, not a pattern, because pattern is a pattern and template is a template. And then once you start from scratch, you need to recall that template, and it will build this automatically based on the template that you saved. Alrighty, that was Logic Pro X. Next we will dive into Studio One. So remember to subscribe for the channel for more content. Thanks for watching. Bye now.